kicks off the week of video blogging leading up to the Smash Master Show. Smash Masters. Potato Mashers. Smash Master Show on May 6th in Troop PA. So that's kind of a home fed type thing. Heavy in a production role, doing some things on screen and off screen. So we'll see what pans out. You never know what might happen in 570 Wrestling. Today, me and Lindsay are headed over to the Battlefield. Hope I'm saying that right. Battlefield Pro Wrestling Show. I really got to look that up so I stop saying their fed name wrong. I'm sorry. Sorry. BPW show, just to be there as fans. So I'll do a couple videos there and just enjoy the action and have a good time and get ready for another tough work week until we get to the weekend where we can have some more fun. So I just posted this on social media. Then I got kind of nervous because I was like, oh, people are going to think I actually have beef with somebody. I don't have no beef. It's more about overall, if you do, come talk to me. Or if not, let's just let bygones be bygones and move on. I'm not the kind of person that focuses on this shit. So just kind of wanted to put it out there for the world on my my shoot account. World Underground referee, hardcore intergender heavyweight, 24x7 lightweight champion of the world. Say that 5 times fast. I'm practicing. So I'm here in the lab, had this set up from when I did ABJ podcast and just never get to use it. So trying to use this microphone to see, you know, how it goes and take some videos, but getting ready to head to Battlefield Pro Wrestling. Got it right this time, BPW in Broadheadsville, Pennsylvania, just as a fan. Taking all the action, check out what's going on, as mentioned before. Took some notes while I was at the gym today. My pre-workout just makes my brain go absolutely insane, so I come up with a bunch of ideas. Texted some of these ideas to people, but these are kind of my personal ideas, so things I need to improve on and do better at ring pace. I've always flew around really, really fast, driven by my anxiety. It's no surprise that everybody who performs in wrestling's got some kind of anxiety, and mine just manifests in moving faster. So I got to slow the fuck down, shake off the ring rust. I don't know yet how that's going to happen. I need to work a little bit in and out of the ring to figure out, get my style back and just kind of make everything feel a little bit more fluid. Also, I need to stand still a little bit. So, by the way, I'm just looking down on my phone where my notes are. I don't know if you can see that or not, but I need to stand still a little bit more as a referee. Got referee on the brain. As a performer, manager, if I'm outside the ring, I have to not run around like an ant to make sure that the eyes stay on the action in the ring. And then my memory, like my last vlog, you kind of got the sold out the business and you got the inside on some of the my finish being called for my match. And the one that wasn't really my match, but we kind of won it because we had a goofy finish. But we went through that match for a lot of different times. And it was like, we're going to do this. And this is act 1. Then we're going to go back here. We're going to do this. And this 17 spots and then 37 things. And then when I do this, you're going to do this. And I'm going to do this. I've never had a memory like that. So kind of intimidating to see the guys go through it like that. I'll practice. I'll get better, especially if I'm using long ass title names like the World Underground Referee Hardcore Intergender Heavyweight 24x7 Lightweight Champion of the World in some of my gimmick stuff. So I'll get better. I'm going to keep practicing and keep making sure my memory's sharp so I can recall all this stuff. But not everything's bad. I like my look. I like what I've developed. My look as a manager. I really enjoy the evolution of JS Michaels and where this is heading. I don't have plans. I'm not one of those people that just plan stuff out. I just kind of figure out stuff on the fly. So, just kind of figured out my look a little bit and still tweaking it a little bit and along the lines of where everything's going. Have good energy, good expression, that pulls people in to things I'm doing. Creativity still off the charts at my age. I have a very crazy job that keeps my brain going, so I do a lot of analysis and calculation, organization, but when I'm outside of the office, my creativity spikes, especially in the morning, so that's awesome. And also like the edge that J.S. Michaels is developing. I like the social media content. I've got to pace it a little better, but all in all, good. So, just, sometimes we just have to be honest with ourselves about what we're good at, what we need to improve on, and go from there. So, on the road to Battlefield Pro Wrestling.
The world underground referee, hardcore, intergender, heavyweight, 24x7 lightweight champion of the world. Acknowledge me!
Acknowledge me!
Acknowledge me!
No, acknowledge me!
I acknowledge that we have to leave or we're going to be late. Hi, my name is Mark and we're going to see some wrestling!
So being a fan is a lot more chill. I don't do anything. I just get to sit here and get entertained. It's kind of weird. Okay, a little bit uncomfortable.
So this one is the Yingling Pride. This one is deep-rooted, so it's our root beer that we brew, kind of like a Not Your Father's, but better. And then this one here is a seltzer, and then I have different flavors here if you would like. I have grapefruit, wild berry, or lemon and lime.
Enough of this fucking dried basil bullshit. That shit on your cornea is not going to be cool. Nor is it visually effective. So from now on, it's fresh basil, bitches.
Intermission, this is when everybody after intermission is freaking out going, oh shit, let's go over a match one more time. So, kind of missed the stress. I said it was weird before being a fan. Yeah, completely. Me and Lindsay were just talking. We're like, we need something to do. We need to do something. We can't just sit here.
So it's Monday of show week. I just got back from a doctor's appointment. Everything's going good. So at my age, every 6 months, they have to check my blood pressure and stuff to make sure that didn't go crazy again.
take blood pressure medication just to make sure all that stuff stays stable and I stay healthy and all that fun stuff, so I could do cool things like this. I was listening to ABJ podcast a little bit last night with Ricky Price. They made a really good point at the beginning about kind of how you don't know that, you know, you don't think of pro wrestlers as real people almost because they're kind of right in front of you. They're playing a character. You try to imagine somebody like a Ricky Price or a J.S. Michaels doing normal things and you're like, that's not possible. He's a jackass or they're jackasses. And yeah, but true story, we also are real people. Have to do real things like go to the doctors and stuff and go to work. So just get ready for a long-ass work week. Hopefully it goes by fast. It's as low stress as possible in the field that I'm in. Last night, of course, we went to the Battlefield Pro Wrestling Show. They have a crazy setup, so it looks like really professional. So it's almost like going to, you know, in a way, WWE Junior for those who aren't, you know, familiar with indie wrestling. It's kind of one of the... They bring in a lot of big names, but then they develop their own talent. So it's run by Offa Jr., son of the Wild Samoan, famous Wild Samoan Offa. You know, the whole Samoan bloodline and everything. That said, you know, not my style indie wrestling, not my style of wrestling that I personally am into, but it was a really cool setup, and it's, you know, awesome that you know, kids coming up have such a crazy, you know, crazy venue to spend their time at and train at. Certainly professional. There's a full gym there. You know, rings, you know, lights, sound. I mean, it's pro. It's pro. And, you know, more power to them and, you know, best of luck there. And I'm sure they don't even need my luck or wishes because they are, you know, they've got what they've got going on. And, you know, Alpha's got a good thing there. So now it's about time to get ready for work and face the day. So talk to you soon.
What's up, Ollie? What are they doing? Hi, guys.
Do you want a burger?
Burger?
I'll take two.
Burger?
Burger?
And then he was like, ma'am, do you do anything else for charity or just fuck your husband?
What beer are you looking up?
Gogglefogger.
What the hell is a Gogglefogger?
It's a Hefeweizen.
A Hefeweizen?
It's a wheat beer, a Hefeweizen.
What's it called?
Gogglefogger.
Say it faster.
No.
What the fuck?
I
know exactly who AJ Hawk looks like.
All those moments to get to the
Avatar.
He's an NFL player. Like you heard that in the, hey, you want to come to work? That was really cool.
I don't have any sponsors, but we'll just talk a little bit here. Thank you guys so much. George in the chat now. Mo Folk and Ricky Price. That's that George. Me and George now have like a little rivalry going, but it was a one-time thing. I think it's a lot of fun.
get ready to head out and unload a ring today. So you don't hear that from people every day, but heading over to Ross's to get the new Smashmaster ring.
C-channel?
But they're going to get ratcheted in anyway.
Yeah, that's why I said we don't have to use that. We just want to get a ruler. Or not a ruler, but a level. Put a line here. Cut it across.
Day after ring setup, I am so gym is tough today. But before you know it, it'll be show day.
Hi. Hi, Ms. Bell.
Those calves.
So that's the end of that workout. We're about 2 days out from show day. Saturday, looking forward to it. Just got 2 more days of work to get through and power through. And then it'll be time to get ready for Smash 7 in Shrewd, Pennsylvania. Exciting news that I saw on the internet last night. It looks like Adina Steele was on AEW Dark. That's huge for us. All of us in Smash Master, all of us in 570, which is our area code in Northeast PA. We're all excited for the scene. It's not necessarily that all of us or even some of us have the goal of getting to WWE, but it's getting more recognition on the brand and just opening the doors for the people that really have the talent, ambition, work ethic, and really want to make it out there to WWE, AEW, etc. So, you know, very, very big news, very exciting stuff for all of us here at Smash. So pretty pumped going into the Smash show. Not just because of my workout. Lots of cool stuff going on. It's a show that I don't think anybody should want to miss, because you're going to miss some really crazy things go down. And this whole Smash series coming up for spring into summer is going to be an awesome, awesome just run of different shows, talent, stories. So stay tuned.
Note to Selves is the one and only video blog for the experienced J.S. Michaels and is supported by WrestleTees.com. WrestleTeez.com starts with Wrestle and uniquely ends with the Z. WrestleTees is your one-stop shop for unique wrestling t-shirts and other stuff centered around the Eastern PA wrestling scene. Pick up your PA effing wrestling shirts today. All orders are made on demand and shipped to you directly. Save 10% on your order with promo code NOTE. That's N-O-T-E. Also, if you're interested in selling your shirts on WrestleTees, I'll create you a custom shirt design and sell it via my WrestleTees store so you have no hassle. DM me at ExperienceJSMichaels on Instagram with any questions. The other way you can get shirts from WrestleTees and from me is to find my merch table at a local Northeast PA wrestling show. Also, please support my friends' ventures. Your local 570 Scranton-Wilkes-Barre wrestling scene in Pennsylvania is booming. Check out Smash Master Wrestling and BYO Wrestling. Search for upcoming events and get some more information on the shows by checking out Smash Master Wrestling and BYO Wrestling on Facebook and Instagram. Sponsorships are also available that include free tickets and ad spots on their broadcasts. Also, if you're looking for a really cool wrestling-centered podcast, the ABJ Podcast with host Anthony Blackwell Jr. brings you rare and out-of-character interviews with some of your favorite up-and-coming and established indie wrestlers in Northeast PA and otherwise, as well as supporting cast and crew and other non-wrestling content. Check out the ABJ Podcast wherever you listen to your pods or in video format on YouTube.